गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैड लुक्ड इनटू फ्यू प्रोग्रामिंग एग्जांपल्स एंड वी हैड कंप्लीटेड लॉजिकल इंस्ट्रक्शंस, राइट? वी सॉ इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी कंप्लीटेड लॉजिकल इंस्ट्रक्शंस, ANL एंडिंग, ORL ORing, XRL XORing, कॉम्प्लीमेंट क्लियर एंड रोटेट इंस्ट्रक्शंस, रोटेट लेफ्ट एंड राइट विथ कैरी विदाउट कैरी। सो कंसिडरिंग दोज एरिथमेटिक एंड लॉजिक इंस्ट्रक्शंस वी टुक फ्यू प्रोग्रामिंग एग्जाम्पल्स। ओके, टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट विथ ब्रांचिंग इंस्ट्रक्शन, प्रोग्राम ब्रांचिंग इंस्ट्रक्शंस। नाउ फ्रॉम द नेम इट सेल्फ, प्रोग्राम मेमरी इज नथिंग बट द रॉम मेमरी, राइट? सो वी विल बी राइटिंग इंस्ट्रक्शन टू जम्प इन रॉम मेमरी लोकेशंस। ओके, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड प्रोग्राम ब्रांचिंग इंस्ट्रक्शंस। नाउ दीज आर द इंस्ट्रक्शंस लिस्टेड हियर। एल जम्प, दैट एल स्टैंड्स, JMP फॉर जम्प, एल स्टैंड्स फॉर लॉन्ग, ए जम्प, ए स्टैंड्स फॉर एब्सोल्यूट जम्प, एस जम्प शॉर्ट जम्प एंड JMP जम्प। द रिमेनिंग इज जम्प ऑन जीरो JZ, जम्प ऑन नो जीरो JNZ, DJNZ विच वी हैव यूज्ड इट बिफोर, डिक्रीमेंट एंड जम्प ऑन नो जीरो, CJNE कंपेयर एंड जम्प ऑन नॉट इक्वल, ए फॉर एब्सोल्यूट कॉल, लॉन्ग कॉल, रिटर्न एंड रिटर्न फ्रॉम इंटरप्ट। सो दीज आर द इंस्ट्रक्शंस अंडर द कैटेगरी प्रोग्राम ब्रांचिंग इंस्ट्रक्शंस, राइट? नाउ फ्रॉम दीज द वन शोन इन रेड कलर आर अनकंडीशनल जम्प इंस्ट्रक्शंस, whereas JZ, JNZ, DJNZ, CJNE are, these are the four conditional jump instruction, and there is JC and JNC also, right students? So the ones written in red color are unconditional jump. It means when microcontroller is executing that unconditional jump instruction, the jump has to take place. Correct. It's unconditional. The jump has compulsory to take place. Fine. Now, see, whenever the instruction is executed, mean what are you doing? Microcontroller is jumping to some another memory location and starting the program execution from that new location. Correct. So mean what are these jump instructions? So what are these jump instructions going to do? These jump instructions are going to modify program counter. Why? Because program counter is the one which stores the address of program memory. And all these instructions are related to jump in program memory. Right? So all these instructions are going to change the program counter. Keep this in mind. Fine. Now let us start with unconditional jumps first, right? Now whatever jumps you all have, L jump, A jump, S jump, all these are unconditional jump. And why are they categorized like this? L stands for long, A for absolute, S for short. So that depends on the range of jump instructions, right? So depending on how far microcontroller can jump, these instructions have been categorized as L, A, and S. So here there is a diagram shown, that blue color box you see. It's a diagram shown for ROM memory. Now, what is the maximum ROM memory that you interface? It is 64 KB, out of which you can have a combination of internal, external, and internal plus external. So altogether, we have shown here 64 KB ROM memory from 000, that is 000 hex to FFFF. These are 64,000 memory locations. Now, if the jump can be anywhere in 64 KB range, then it is called as long jump. So long jump is categorized as the name itself, long. Anywhere within the 64 KB memory, the jump can take place. Hence the name long jump. Correct? Next, absolute jump. A jump is absolute jump. The range of the jump is within 2 KB memory, that is 2000 byte memory locations. We cannot go beyond 2 KB. The jump has to take place within 2000 memory locations. So that is the word absolute indicating. Correct? And this 2 KB, this range is called as a page memory. The range of 2000 locations is called as a page memory. Correct? Now the total memory, total ROM memory is 64,000, 64 KB. One page is of 2 KB. Therefore, microcontroller has 64 divided by 2. That is 32 page memories. Okay. So in 8051, page memory is nothing but the size of 2 KB memory. The total memory is 64 KB. Hence, we have 32 pages. An absolute jump is within a page. Right, students? Okay. Now, the next one is S-jump, short jump. From the name itself, the range of jump is within 256 bytes. The range is within 256 memory locations. Hence, the name short. Right. So, depending on how far the jump is, correct? How far the jump is, we have long jump within 64 KB, absolute jump within 2 KB, and short jump within 256 bytes. Okay. So, that is the range, right? Hence, they are categorized accordingly. Now the jump. S jump, A jump, L jump can be anywhere in that 64 KB memory. It can be within internal, it can be within external, right? So that's anywhere. Just note the ranges. This range, 256 byte, can be in internal ROM, can be in external ROM. 2 KB can be a part of internal ROM or an external ROM. Okay. So it's just depending on the range. So we are starting with unconditional jump, and the first one is long jump, LJMP. Unconditional means the execution or the jump has to take place. Unconditional. Now long jump, how is the format? You write LJump, that is a mnemonic, and mention the 16-bit address where the jump has to take place. Okay, so LJump, ADDR16 is, give a 16-bit address. Now that the range is within 64 KB ROM memory. And as I told you all these jump instructions are going to change program counter. Okay. So then what is the explanation? Give a 16-bit ROM memory address in the instruction or give a label. Now if you remember, we had done programming. We had run S jump up, S jump stop, S jump start. So what did we do? We gave labels, right? But then you should, the compiler takes care of what is that exact address to be put. Okay. But then you should actually know how is the instruction format. What does it expect? Enter some 16-bit ROM address. Okay. Now, how many byte the instruction is? See, you have one 16-bit number in the instruction. Mean the instruction is a 3-byte instruction. First byte is the opcode. Second byte is the address, 8-bit address. Third byte is the another 8-bit address. So it is a 3-byte instruction. And all the jump instructions are of 2 machine cycles. They take a time of 2 machine cycle. That is 24 clock pulses are required for execution. So all the program branching is of 2 machine cycles. Right? Whereas the byte, it depends on is it L jump, S jump or A jump. L jump, 3 byte. Okay, see the example given, L jump 34FC hex. So we have entered one 16-bit number. And what is that 16-bit number? Address of memory location where the microcontroller should jump. So from 34FC hex, the instruction execution should begin. Okay, so what did we say? Program counter gets modified. How does it get modified? Whatever address you mention, 34FC, gets copied in program counter. See the last line. 34FC hex gets copied in program counter. That's simple. Okay, so the new execution, microcontroller jumps from this address and starts executing the program from the new address. Now I have just mentioned at the top, PC plus 3 is copied in PC. To this L jump instruction, this is of not that relevance. But when we will study absolute jump and when we will study short jump, what is the current PC matters a lot, right? But for long jump, it does not matter. It's as simple as whatever address you mention gets copied in program counter. Whatever be the earlier program counter value, it does not matter. Okay. But then why the statement is written like this? See, what is program counter? What is the function of program counter? Program counter always points to the next instruction which is to be fetched. Mean, when microcontroller is executing L jump instruction, program counter will show what is the next instruction that is to be executed. Now, L jump when we write, how many memory locations L jump will take? L jump will require 3 memory locations because it is a 3-byte instruction. Correct. So my next instruction will be written 3 locations ahead. Hence it is said, what is the actual, when L jump is getting executed, what is the address in program counter? Program counter will be point to the next instruction. Where is the next instruction? 3 locations ahead. So it is PC plus 3 is the value of program counter when L jump is getting executed. Okay, so just remember this, because this PC plus 3, PC plus 2 is very important during absolute jump and short jump. Okay, so we will just see this example in more detail. L jump 34FC. So that's an example, L jump 34FC hex. This address will be copied in program counter. Now, how many byte? The instruction is 3 byte. So look into the table. Before execution, we have shown internal ROM, external ROM. It's a ROM memory where we write a program. So internal ROM we have written, suppose. So in internal ROM, 100 hex the instruction is written. At 100 hex, we have written L jump 34FC. So it is 3 bytes. So at 100 location, this is an opcode. 2 hex is opcode of jump instruction, L jump instruction. And then we have mentioned an address. So this address is also part of the instruction. So look into that higher address, 34 hex is stored first. So at 100, we have opcode. At 101 address, we have higher address. And at 102, we have lower jump address. Usually, when the opcode is formed, we have the opcode first, then the lower address, then the higher address. But here there is something different. In L jump instruction, we have opcode first, then we have higher address, and then we have lower address. So that's how the instruction is stored in ROM memory, 3 bytes. Okay, and what is the execution? Simply these two numbers are to be picked up and stored in program counter. So when this instruction jump is getting executed, jump is written as what at 100? What will program counter show? The next instruction. Where is the next instruction? At 103. So before execution, mean before the jump gets executed, program counter will show 103, right? And it is executing the jump. When the jump instruction executes, see the after execution column. Program counter will be simply loaded with the address mentioned in the instruction, 34FC hex. Okay, students? Right. So that is long jump. Now we will go to, okay. So now see, we do not bother about the addresses. We just, while writing the program, I'll be writing L jump up. L jump is a mnemonic and up is a label given by the user, the programmer. Compiler will find out to which instruction the up label is given. What is the address of that instruction? It takes that address, copies in program counter. So as a programmer, I never worry about what the addresses are, how far the jump is. We just simply write the label, right? So the instructions that we write is L jump up. All the jump instructions are written with the help of labels. And it is a compiler, it is the assembler which does all these things. Find out the label address, Okay. Now, in case of assembler, you have two options, one pass assembler and two pass assembler. Now, in 8086, whatever kits you all were using, students, those kits had one pass assembler software in it. So, therefore, whenever you did write jump instruction, you had to mention the correct address. Labels are not recognized by one pass assemblers. So, although 8086 kits had one pass assembler, hence you had to mention the jump instruction something like this, JMP and the correct address. Right? And I don't know, did you all do 8086 programming using MASM software? MASM, MASM, which is to be executed on PCs. MASM is a two pass assembler. And in two pass assembler, I'm allowed to use labels. Correct. So MASM is a software which is a two pass assembler for 8086, and the kits that you used were one pass assembler. In one pass assembler, mention the address, whereas in two pass assembler, we can use labels. So whatever Keel Microvision software we are using, it has a two pass assembler. Hence, it allows us to write labels in the instruction. Okay, students. That was long jump. Now we go for absolute jump. How is the format? It's again unconditional. And how is the format? AJMP and mention an 11-bit address. Earlier L jump, what did we do? ADDR16. That is, mention a 16-bit address in long jump. Now in absolute jump, I only need to mention 11-bit address. Why 11-bit? Look at the range. What is the range that the jump occurs within 2000 memory locations? It means the range is of 2000 addresses. 2000 addresses, how do I get? 2 raised to 11 is 2000. Exact is 2048. So 2 raised to 11 gives me 2000 addresses. What is that 11? These many bits in the address. Hence, in a jump instruction, programmer needs to give only 11-bit address. Okay, why? Because it's a range of jump, 2 KB memory. Okay, so what does programmer need to give? Give an 11-bit ROM address that is called as a page memory address in the instruction, or give a label, even that is okay. Compiler and the assembler will find out the 11-bit address. Okay. But then program counter is 16-bit. So this 11-bit address is combined with program counter to get a 16-bit address. How does it do that? The last 5 bits of program counter do not change. Program counter is 16-bit. 11 bits you have given in the instruction. The remaining 5 bits are the program counter 5 bits, higher bits are kept as it is. And the 11 bits are attached to the program counter. Okay, so A jump 11 bits of the address. Now, how many byte is the instruction? It is 2 byte. See, 1 byte is an opcode, and second byte is that 11-bit address. 2 machine cycle. Okay, now you should think, if opcode is 8-bit and the second number is also 8-bit, then there's how does 11-bit address fit in an 8-bit number? We said it is 2-byte instruction. 2 byte means 2 8-bit numbers. Correct. But this is not an 8-bit number. This is an 11-bit number. How it is done then? Right. So let us how it is done. We are going to see next. How it is done is from this 11 bits, 8-bit, lower 8-bit become 1 byte. And whatever the 3 bits are remaining of an address gets combined in the opcode, 8-bit opcode. Again, I repeat, this 11-bit address, so A0 to A7, A8, A9, so A0 to A10 are the 11 address bits. Correct. Out of that, A0 to A7 is 1 byte, and 8, 9, 10, address 8, address 9, and address 10 combine with the opcode, and that becomes 1 byte. and hence it becomes a 2-byte instruction. Okay, we will see how it is. So for example, if I have written A jump 05FC hex, now I need to know program counter. What is the address of program counter? So let me see one example here. See, one example is written. Okay. Now we will see how the opcode is formed as well as what is the new address in program counter obtained. Okay, just remember we have written A jump and some address. What happens is program counter points to the next instruction. A jump is 2 byte, so program counter will be incremented by 2 so that it is pointing to the next instruction. So PC plus 2 happens and then PC is modified with some number. So we will see that modification. So we will see opcode formation as well as PC program counter modification. So I have written that jump instruction AJMP 5FC hex. That's an 11-bit address. Okay, 5FC hex. A jump 11-bit address. And where have I written this A jump? In program memory. What is the address of program memory? The address of program memory is 7900 hex. Mean in some external ROM, this instruction is written. 7900 is a ROM address. Okay, and the jump should happen to this 11-bit address. Fine. Now, how is the opcode created? We said it is a 2-byte instruction. So from this 11-bit address, this is that 8-bit address comprising that 1 byte. So A0 to A7 is that 1 byte of the instruction. And the remaining 3 bits, A8, A9, A10, look into A8, A9, A10 is clubbed with the opcode. What is the opcode? 501. So 1 is an opcode. And in this opcode bit, the address bits are included, A8, A9, A10. And that's how the 11-bit ad in spite of 11-bit address, the instruction is 2 bytes. Okay. Opcode combined with the 3-bit address and the lower 8-bit address make a 2-byte instruction. Okay. So what is my lower 8 bits? FC. So see here, this is 1111F and C is 12, 1100FC. And the upper 3 bits are 5. So 8, A9, A10 is 5, 101. And 0, 401, this is 0001 is an opcode of A jump. So what is my opcode altogether? 1010 is A and that's 1. So my first byte is A1 hex and the second byte is FC hex. That's how the opcode is formed. A1 and the second byte is FC, 2-byte instruction. Okay, students. And now, what is the program counter going to have? What new address program counter is going to have? Program counter is instruction is written at 7900. Program counter will point to the next instruction means 2 bytes ahead. So what is initial program counter? 7902. PC plus 2. What is PC? 7900 plus 2 becomes 7902. Correct. So what is my initial program counter? It is showing this address 7902. Ahead, I have only written it in binary and have highlighted the upper 5 bits. What are the upper 5 bits? 0111. What is the 11-bit address mentioned? 5FC. So I have written it in binary 05FC. Now, how is new program counter going to get? The upper 5 bits remain the same. And the 11 address bits gets appended. So what are the upper 5 bits? 0111, red color, upper 5 bits. And what are the lower 11 bits? 11-bit address from the instruction. What is that? 5FC. So see here, 51015, F 1111, and C 1100. So what is my new program counter? That's how my new address is generated. The red 5 bits remain the same, and the 11 bit from the address from the instruction gets appended. So the new address is 7 0111 is 7, 1101 is 13, so that's D, 41s is F, and 1100 is 12, that is C. So my new address is 7DFC. Do you get me, students? This is where the jump is going to take place. From 7900, microcontroller is going to jump to 7DFC. Okay. One more example. One more we will see. A jump, the same address, 5FC. But now, where is that instruction written? The instruction is written at 100. Okay. Earlier, where was the instruction written? 7900. This memory location, the instruction was written. Now, the same instruction is written at 100 location. Okay. So, now what is an opcode? 11 bits FC and the three numbers 5. So, the opcode is the same, A1FC. Correct, because the instruction is the same, but my program counter is different. What is my program counter? My initial program counter is now showing 102 hex. A jump is written at 100, mean the next instruction is 2 bytes ahead, 102. So what is my initial program counter? 102. So I have only written it in binary, 0102, and I have highlighted the last 5 bits. Okay, what is the 11 bit address given in the instruction? 5FC. This 5FC will get appended to the program counter. So what are the upper 5 bits of program counter? 5 zeros, because the instruction is written at 100, 0100. So what are the upper 5 bits? 5 zeros, and that 5FC gets appended, 5101, F1111 and C. So now what is a new address generated, students, here? The red color is 0, next is 5, next is F, next is C. So what is a new address? 05FC. Correct. Now this seems to be similar. It just seems to be similar because the upper 5 bits were 000. Whereas in my earlier example, what was the new address? 70FC. The upper 5 bits do not change. My upper 5 bits were 0111. Here the upper 5 bits are 000. And hence my new address is 5FC hex. So that's what the explanation is. A jump 5FC, what is the new program counter depends on what is the initial value of program counter. How is the initial value calculated? PC plus 2 is the new value. And to this PC, that 5FC gets appended. Okay, student, have you all understood this absolute jump? Very good, students. We were at absolute jump, right? Just to explain the last same instruction, just in a tabular format, it is a jump 5FC, right? We have written it at 100. What was the opcode formation? See here, students, it was A1FC. So 2-byte instruction, A1 is an opcode, FC is the lower address, right? What is the execution? This address gets appended with the upper 5 bits and is stored in program counter. What is program counter? 102. So the higher 5 bits are kept as it is and the lower 11 bits are appended. So the new address is 5FC. Now, coincidentally, the new address came as similar to the address mentioned in the instruction. Why? Because the upper 5 bits of the program counter were 0000. Okay, students. Now, we do not bother about all these things, appending that address and what is program counter. We just write a label that's taken by the compiler and the assembler. I, as a programmer, will only write a label. A jump up and up is mentioned to some instruction. Okay, students. Now we'll go for the next, that is short jump. And it's again an unconditional, mean the jump has to take place. It has to go to some new address. Okay, so S stands for short. The range is 256 byte. Up and down, the total range is 256 memory locations. Okay, now how is the instruction? SJUMP REL. It's telling one, REL stands for relative. What is relative? Give an 8-bit signed number. Mean mention one positive number or a negative number. Okay. Now, if it is a forward jump, if you are going to jump two locations ahead, we say it is a forward jump. So, if it is a forward jump, we mention positive number. And what is that number? How many locations ahead? Jump to an instruction 8 locations ahead. Jump to an instruction 16 locations ahead. So that is called forward jump. And forward jump mean I need to mention a positive number. And if the jump is backward, go 8, jump to 8 locations behind, jump to 10 locations behind. So to represent backward jump, we mention a negative number. A negative 8-bit number or a positive 8-bit number. Forward positive, backward negative. And the negative number is represented using 2's complement format. Okay. And the negative number is 2's complement representation. So if I have 8-bit 2's complement number, then the range is plus 127 locations ahead and minus 128 locations behind. Okay, so that's the characteristics of 2's complement number. If it is an 8-bit 2's complement number, what is the range? Plus 127, minus 128. All together becomes 256. Hope you all are getting me, students. How is the range? 256 locations. How do you get 256 locations? Wherever you write the jump instruction, we can go plus 127 locations ahead or minus 128 locations behind. So this plus 127 and 128 locations behind all together makes it 256. All together it becomes a range of 256 memory addresses, memory locations. Right? So the format is SJUMP and some number, 8-bit number. Positive number for forward jump, negative number for backward jump. Okay. Now, how many byte SJUMP opcode? And that's one 8-bit number. So it is a 2-byte instruction. And it's a program branching mean 2 machine cycle. So 2-byte, 2 machine cycle instruction. So see, for example, we have written SJUMP and 0C hex. That's an 8-bit number 0C. What is it? Is it a positive or a negative number? Check the sign bit, the seventh bit. So 0C mean the seventh bit is 0. Mean this number is a positive number. Correct, students? How to recognize whether it's a positive or a negative number? Check the seventh bit. If the seventh bit is 0, mean positive, forward jump. If the seventh bit is negative, mean it's backward jump. So what is it telling you? Whatever number is written in the instruction gets added to the program counter and the new address is created. So the number gets added in program counter. But then you should know what is the actual, what is the value of program counter correct. So when jump is getting executed, program counter points to the next instruction. The jump is 2 byte, mean the next instruction will be 2 locations ahead. So what is my correct program counter? Correct program counter is PC plus 2. And to this PC plus 2, that 12 gets added. Hope you all are getting me, students. So for example, SJUMP is written at 100 location. So what is the correct program counter? The correct address of program counter is 102. And to this 102, C will be added. Correct. 100 location, 100 location. The correct value of PC is the next instruction, 102. And to this 102, the number gets added. since it's a forward positive number, addition takes place. If it's a negative number, subtraction takes place. So PC is 102. 102 plus C. C is 12. So 12 and two locations. So what is that jump? CDE. The jump address is 10E. Correct. 102 plus 12. The address is 10E. Okay, let us take an example of backward jump. Okay. So what instruction I'll be writing here, students? S jump FB hex. See at the slide S jump instruction. Suppose I have written S jump FB. Now you should understand F means the last seventh number is one. It means that's a negative number. FB is a negative number. And the jump is going to take backward. Now we will see how did this FB come? How could I get this number FB? Okay, so look at the left hand side of your screen. Some small program has been written. It's some random program given just to explain that S jump. So at 100 location, it is move R2 comma 00. It's a 2 byte instruction. So the next instruction is 102, move A comma 45 something. It's again 2 byte. The next 104 is some move R5. So this is 1 byte. Now the jump is written at 105 students. S jump, and we have given some label. But where is that S jump written? At 105. Where is the label? It's backward. The jump is going to take place backward. At what location? 102. Okay. So how is that program counter getting modified? We will see, students. So the jump is written at 105. Program counter will point to the next instruction, mean it will be showing increment R2. Where is increment R2? At address 107. Mean program counter is showing 107 when it is executing S jump. Okay. Where is the jump to take place? 102. So look at the right hand side. What is program counter? It's currently at 107. Jump should take place at 102. Mean what's the difference of memory locations? Five locations backward. The jump should take place five locations back. Five locations back means it's minus five. How do you write minus five in two's complement? You first write five in binary. So that's 000 and 0101. So that's the number five in binary. You take one's complement of this number. So one's complement of this is 1111 and 1010. So that's one's complement of 505. So that's FA. And how do you take two's complement? Add one to one's complement. So one's complement plus one becomes two's complement. So FA plus one becomes FB. So five locations back means it's minus five. So minus 5, if you want to calculate manually, 2's complement of minus 5 is FB. Correct. So the instruction should have been S jump FB hex. That's a backward jump. Okay, students. So just let me know how is this done. Forward jump, you just write the number. That number gets added to PC plus 2. If it's a backward jump, then the location, see the locations, five locations back. So minus 5 is FB, right? So this PC plus 2 plus FB. What is FB? Minus 5. So it is as if PC plus 2 plus of minus 5. And that's how it goes five locations back. Hope you all are getting me. But then we do not worry about the addresses. We do not worry how far ahead, how far back. We just write S jump up. The compiler, the assembler will find. Is it plus 5? Is it minus 5? Okay, students. Short jump, did you all understand? So, short jump, you mention one 8-bit number. And what is that 8-bit number? If it is a forward jump, it is one 8-bit positive number. If it is a backward jump, it is an 8-bit negative number. Forward jump, you can go 127 locations ahead. For backward jump, you can go 128 locations back. So just we will see the comparison and we will stop, students. So we saw A jump, S jump, and L jump. We'll see the some comparison in short. So we are comparing L jump, A jump, S jump, and what are the parameters we are comparing? How many byte the instruction are? L jump was 3 byte, A jump, S jump was 2 byte instruction. How many machine cycles? All of them will take 2 machine cycles. That is 24 clock pulses to execute. What is the range of jump? Long jump is within 64 KB memory. Absolute jump, 2 KB memory. Short jump, 256 byte memory. That's the range. What is the width of jump address? In long jump, we need to give 16-bit address. Absolute jump, 11-bit address. And short jump, we need to give 8-bit number. That's not an address. We need to give 1 8-bit number. What happens with PC, program counter? In long jump, program counter is directly loaded with the address mentioned in the instruction. Absolute jump, 11-bit address appended with program counter. So the 11-bit address directly copied in 11 bits of program counter. Whereas short jump, whatever number you give, it gets added to program counter. Okay, so here the 16-bit address is directly loaded, 11-bit address directly appended, whereas in short jump, the number gets added to program counter. Okay, the next comparison parameter is forward and backward jump possible? Yes, it's possible in all the three. Okay, mention the addresses in the first two cases. Here, mention the number, positive number forward, negative number backward. Hand coding, is it, how is hand coding? Hand assembly mean, can you manually get the opcodes? In L jump, yes, but in absolute jump and short jump, you need to do some calculations. In absolute jump, you need to do appending, and in short jump, you need to add the program counter. So hand coding is easier for long jump, but it's a bit difficult for absolute and short jump. Okay. Now, address of next byte of instruction mean program counter address, is it important? For long jump, it is not. Whatever address you mention gets loaded in program counter. But in absolute jump and short jump, I need to know the exact address of program counter. If I'm doing hand coding, hand assembly, I need to know the program counter addresses. It's important to know the next byte address, next instruction address. And to be used, when is to be used? Long jump, anywhere in 64 KB. So there is no space restriction. But absolute jump, there is a space, 2 KB range, space restriction. Short jump, yes, there is a space restriction within 256 bytes. Okay, students. So for today, let me stop here, students. So thank you everyone for attending, and see you all in the next session. Okay.